I had no intention of setting up feeding families. It really all came about by chance. I came across a family with my husband who were in desperate, desperate need, just a mile from where we lived. This lady had 5 children under the age of 7 and no furniture in the house at all. And in that moment, we just tried to help her and we got her some food. And really it all sort of snowballed from there. We are currently helping about 300 other charities, schools and local organisations. We provide food in bulk to them, which then they can distribute to the people that they work with. That means we've got food all over the northeast that's easily accessible in just about every location.
I volunteer for Feeding Families because it's such a worthwhile cause. There's a huge need in the northeast for help of this kind. People are in real food poverty.
It's a group all together. We're a friendly group. You have your Wednesday group and you have your Thursday group. We even try and get out a couple of nights.
You do know, get to know people and have social at Christmas, you know.
Our volunteers bring so much. It's not just about them giving an hour of their time. It's what they bring to us as a charity. It's the impact they have on us as individuals. And it means that when somebody opens a box, the food isn't thrown in there. It's been packed lovingly by somebody. And you can tell when you open one of our boxes that somebody cares and somebody's thought about you and the value it brings to you to take the time to do it right.
We've seen absolutely massive demand, particularly through the cost of living crisis. Last year we saw a 100% increase in demand. The year before we saw another 100% increase in demand.
There's just too many impactful things happening at the minute. We all know the impact of COVID, leaving the EU, the cost of living, the financial crisis globally. And what that means is that when you add to the structural inequalities that are already there in society around education and employment, is the Northeast is massively affected. Food insecurity is a real thing, whether you're in employment or not. Times are tough and people need help.
I think we can all recognise that we can do something. Our something may seem very small, but all those small things add up to big things.
Supporting Feeding Families is different for every person. So for some people, that might mean donating some money. It might be turning up and volunteering and helping pack our boxes.
You can give a tin of peaches. You can give a packet of rice. Everybody can do something.
Donate, volunteer, spread the word. Anything, anything helps.
I think what we've come to realise is that from a small act of kindness, many, many wonderful things can happen, and that really is the story of Feeding Families. My hope for Feeding Families is that we lock the door, close the building down, and go away because it's not needed. And even if I don't see it in my lifetime, my hope is that no child grows up in poverty, no child grows up in disadvantage, that everybody in this region and beyond has a future, has a hope, and lives their very best life. And if I can play in even slightly to that, I'll be happy.